Hey guys! Today we're making another version of a tiny dollhouse. This time we're making a walnut house for a miniature mouse. Hope you'll enjoy! First you're going to need an empty walnut shell. I then mixed some translucent liquid Sculpey with some acrylic paint, about half and half, and then used this to kind of plaster the walls. This is going to make the walls look a bit more like the walls you'd see inside a house, and not so much like the inside of a walnut shell, and it's also going to leave the surface slightly sticky, which is going to help when you're adding the different components. Next we're going to make the foundation for the floor, and I figured since mice don't study architecture or engineering, tiny pebbles would probably be one of the techniques they would use. I first added some texture using a pointed dotting tool, then added texture to some of the rocks or pebbles using a needle tool, I then went in with some tinfoil and a toothbrush. Add some light tan clay on top for the wooden floors, and add some texture using a toothbrush and a needle tool. I made and pre-baked another piece for the second floor or platform. I attached this using some liquid clay to hold it in a bit more securely, and then baked the walnut shell. I made a tiny ladder and added some texture using the same technique as for the floor. And I made a fireplace, adding texture the same way as with the foundation. Bake both pieces and glue them in place, and then use acrylic paint to paint everything you've made so far. I used brown clay to make some tiny twigs for the fireplace, baked that and added a tiny bit of acrylic paint. I also used some dark red clay to make a chair, and for this one you want to use a toothbrush to add a tiny bit of texture before baking. Instead of making a bed, I just glued in two types of fabric. And then of course no mouse house is complete without a midnight snack. Last item I made as far as the decor goes is just a simple book, and for this one I started out by making the pages, then added the binding, used a needle tool to add a few details, then baked that and painted it using acrylic paint. And finally, I just glued in a tiny bit of preserved moss. Lastly, we're going to be sculpting the mouse itself. For this one, I first added some clay to the tip of needle tool, and then pre-baked that to have a nice base for sculpting. Once again, you want to finish off with some acrylic paint after baking. Glue some ribbon onto the entire one half of the shell, and then on one side you want to glue the ribbon onto the next shell to keep the two together. Really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next tutorial.